to be here, even if it's a double challenge, because all my team, not my team, all the team is now in India, and I just began in this project 1 month ago. And so I learned a lot for doing this presentation, I will say. And the PI, as you say, just went in India 2 weeks ago. So you can imagine that I am here since 1 month, and since 2 weeks, she's not here. So that's not a lot of time to speak with her. So I will try to do my best. And so I am working in this MUYA project, this multimedia YASNA project, which just began 1 year ago, and as it's focused the YASNA, the core ritual of the Zoroastrian religion. The groundbreaking nature of this project lies in the fact that it combines two different approaches. On one side, we have the act of the ritual performance, and on the other one, the manuscript, which contains the text of this ceremony. And we have to deal with these two kinds of data, as we will see. In this approach, the YASNA will be studied both as an event in the form of the ritual performance and as a text in the form of a literary document. This project is led by Almu Tinse, who is just not here today, and there is two postdoctorants for the moment, a third one will arrive in 1 year, and that's the same for the PhD. So the team just increased this year, and so we have to deal with many people. So at the beginning, there were not so many people, so problem arise. More we are, more it's difficult to deal with the files and how we exchange files, of course. After this small introduction, I will now explain as much as I can the data management. My speech will contain two parts, one of the ritual performance and the other one on the manuscript. The first objective of this project is to produce a film of the full YASNA ritual that means more or less 2.5 hours. Recording this ceremony is also important in order to preserve this endangered heritage. Almut is now in India doing this movie with other people. In a first part, we will make a movie, more an anthropological type film, because it will be the entire ceremony, and we will make no cuts and no intervention. And this film will contain subtitles in Avestan, that means transcription of the recitation text into Roman letters, because if it's in Avestan script, it will be difficult to read for most of the people. And in order to make these words which the priest utter available to the observer in both oral and visual form, because it's not always easy to understand what the priest is saying at the moment he's speaking. For transcription and annotation, we will use BOLD, which means basic oral language documentation, in which the priest will repeat their oral performance in a slower and more highly articulated way, so that we can make the transcription because we know the text, but of course there is so small variation, so we have to be very aware of all this variation. And subsequently, the film of the ritual will be segmented into clauses and words, and each segment will be translated and annotated with ELAN, a multimedia tool developed at the Max Planck Institute for Psycholinguistics. And this tool is for the creation of complex annotation on video resources. So the textual content of annotation is always in Unicode, of course, and the transcription is stored in an XML format. On the other side, a shorter movie will be editing with a 360 degrees camera, and we will make some close-up at some part of the ceremony to show specified aspect. And so it will be a movie focusing on certain parts, and in this aspect it will be an edited movie. The subtitles will appear, of course, and furthermore, we will add hotspots. So that means you can click on some word and there will be a link, like an encyclopedia link, and you will have information. And here, that's a project she has made. And so you see this priest, and he's just cutting some plants before the ritual. And you can see that he's pouring water. And if you click on this word, you will have some definition of what he's doing now. And just here at the end, you have what he is reciting just now. So, Shnautra, Aurai, Mazna, and so on. So, you can listen, you can put pause, stop, and have some other information. And so, that will be the edited movie. So, we have two parts. The film recording will be in MP4 for the streaming on the web, but the originals are going to be MTS. There is two professionals, Remy and Anna, who are involved in this project for all the technical aspects of the movie and the recording of it. All this material, video, audio, and annotation, will go into LR, about which Mandana just spoke this morning. Furthermore, we will have photography too, because of course there will be photography of the ceremony, but there is also an aspect of this project about the ritual training of the priest, which are a little bit not well understood or well studied for the moment. And so all this photography, which will be deposited into the SOAS SOBEC database. And so that's for the first part, the ritual performance. The other aspect of the project deals with manuscripts and their treatment and the information they contain. So for this project, we will provide an edition of the Yasna ceremony. And for this, we are combining the latest digital technology with traditional philological techniques. So first thing is, of course, the manuscript. As you know, collecting manuscript is a big work in itself. But we have on this aspect a collaboration with the Avestan Digital Archive, and that's an archive with a lot of manuscripts on it. During the last year, Alberto Cantera and his team have collated manuscripts, and more than 100 manuscripts are now available online. And we will also have access at the manuscript not already online. It takes time to put the manuscript online because each page of each manuscript is indexed with Photoshop, and after we have to put the picture on the website. And with this, we can just make some research, and I can just say, I want this part of the text, this sentence, and which manuscript contains this sentence. So that's very useful to exactly check at one passage. And so, these manuscripts are all on a server, and the picture are in different formats. So we have on the server a PSD format with high quality, but as you say, it's difficult after to upload on a website. And so we have a JPEG format with a quality 100 for the web. So we have two different formats, one for us and one for the website. But the one of the website is fine, but of course it's good to have the other format too. Not all the manuscripts are available on Avestan Digital Archive, as you can easily imagine. And we will also make photographies of manuscripts in collection in India during November, so right now. And these images will also go into the SOAS SOBEC database. And that's the first step, having the manuscript with the text. The second step, already running, is the transcription of manuscripts. We are using a customized online transcription editor, OTE, which automatically encodes the text in XML. And we are using, of course, a Unicode police font. It was developed and implemented by Martin Sievers of the Center for Digital Humanities at the University of Trier. And we are currently adapting it for Avestan because it was made at the beginning for Greek, for the New Testament. And so each person of the project makes transcription of some section of the Yasna. So just here we have this OTE software, and we are writing on it, and we are following the line of the manuscript. So like this, we can have the image of the manuscript and the transliteration who fits perfectly. And we can add a lot of commentary, for example, if it's a prima or seconda manu, if the text is in the margin, if there is uncertain letter, and if there is an uncertain letter, why? Because the badge has a problem, or there is a hole, or I cannot read it clearly, and so on. Or if there is a ritual direction and in which language, and the indication of punctuation. So there is a lot of possibilities, and we are typing that on this OTE software. And after, when we saved, everything is put on our computer on an XML format, and also it's stored on the Trier server. In the near future, data will be stored on your own server at the SOAS. So that's a big job, of course, to make this transliteration. And now, okay, we have all this transliteration, but what next? So the next step will be to use this XML format you have on the computer and to put them in this software named CollateXT. And this this software will make automatically comparing and collating readings of manuscripts and will produce theme in a variety of formats. So we will have with that the indication about the family, the genealogy of the manuscript and all the possibilities. And the result will be taken to make the edition for producing a critical apparatus. This software was already employed, but for the Greek, and so we will have to deal with Avestan. And for the moment, we just have example with the Greek version and the final collation with this critical apparatus. So we will use that, and it will be the opening for the edition part. But we will not stop at this point, because we will make, in a more ancient way, if I can say, also an in-depth philological studies for selected part of the Jasna. So we will make this critical edition with the base of this software, but we will also provide a translation with commentaries and a glossary of the vocabulary in a book. So each collaborator will publish a part of the Jasna. And so that's the data which we are dealing with. And so I hope I answer to the most of this question here. And for being honest, for the last one, for posterity, for me it's a big problem to answer to this type of question, because we have already seen that the project had just a 5 years duration, but what after? And not only that, 20 years ago when I used my computer, I was sure I will open my data very easily 10 years after, and that's not the truth. So I am speaking here with this XML format and so on, but will that be used in 20 years? I have no idea at all. So I think it's not only the website on which you are putting your database, but how the technology will be evolved in the next year. So for the moment, I don't have an answer to this question. And for the rest, I think I have finished on time.
I'll ask one question. It sounded like you said that people Photoshop the pictures of manuscripts.
Yeah, for the on the Avestan Digital Archive, yes.
That seems like a bad thing.
Why?
Depends on what they're doing.
What are they doing? Are they color correcting?
No, no. In fact, we are taking the photography and we are just taking one page. We add blank in all parts. And on this blank part, we are putting here the name of the folio. And just here, we are putting the name of the library.
Okay, never mind. That sounds okay.
Here we are putting the name of the library and the name of the manuscript.
Yes.
And here, Avestan Digital Archive. And here we are just putting at which line begins the sentence. So it's just a way to search very easily. And on the photography, we are not really doing something. It's just that we are cutting here for not having all the, I don't know, sometimes when you have a photography here, you have a finger.
Yeah.
It's not very useful. So we are just cutting and just keeping the photography up as she does.
And
she
the file is being edited as a TIFF at this point?
No, at this point we are on Photoshop, and so the first is saved as a PSD, so I think it's a format for Photoshop. And the second one is saved for the web archive. You have a special clause in Photoshop. It's written saved as web archive or something like that. And this one is in JPEG. And you can just choose at this moment the quality, and we choose the higher one, I think 100. And this photo is downloaded on the website. But on the server, we have this PSD version and the JPEG version.
But so you're using the PSD version as the high quality archival version?
Only on the server, but
on
not
server.
On internet.
They're
because it's more or less impossible to upload photography very big.
Yeah.
So, and there is, we have 100 manuscripts, they are for the moment 100 manuscripts. And you have, I don't know, 600 pages for each manuscript. So, and it's only the beginning. So, it's not possible to make that with another higher quality. But this quality is good. And on the website, you have this page which just appear, and after you can click on the page, and it just come bigger, and you can bigger the size again, and you can see very clearly.
And when you crop, do you ensure that you retain the edges?
When,
you crop the image,
yeah, sorry.
Right, do you ensure that you retain the edges of the manuscript?
I written what?
The edge.
So, do you occasionally slice the edge of the manuscript?
Yeah, that's true that it's not perfect. And they have, it begins in 2010, so it was the beginning, and there is a lot of collaborator, not so many, but some collaborator, and so we have some instruction. And now they just decided to make a facsimile version of one manuscript. And they have seen the problem because each picture has a different size.
Yeah.
Because we are cutting, but of course if it's here, I don't know, perhaps I will cut here for the next page. And so we can read the text. For reading the text, it's not a problem. But if you want to make after an edition and thinking that it's exactly the same, no. But we also have the original picture on the server.
Yeah.
Not for everyone, but we are keeping this original picture. So if we want to see really something, we can just go at the first version and see.
Yeah. So then the other question I had, especially for the field work that's being done now in India, is when you take a picture, do you take the picture with an object of known size and color? So that in the image you have embedded the information about the manuscript size and you can make any color adjustments?
Normally for the manuscript we have a scale just next to the manuscript and with this color for having an ID. After, I will be honest, I was not here each time the manuscript was digitized, and so perhaps it's not the case for all the manuscripts. Because sometimes we have a lot of time, so we can do it. Sometimes you are just in a quick time and you are just doing what you can because you don't know if next time you will have the occasion to take again the photography.
Purely
yeah.
A technical question. How do you ensure that you get a flat image, that you're perpendicular to the surface of the
image? A flat image.
How do you ensure that your camera is exactly perpendicular to your piece of paper?
So now they are in India and they have something very big like that, and there is some light, and so you just put the manuscript on and the camera is fixed.
Right.
And there is some light just going on the manuscript for avoiding the shadow and so on. And so like this, the manuscript is here, the light, the camera. Normally it's quite like that.
Other questions? Okay. Then I'll just make a comment actually for both you and to Luke. It's our understanding of ERC regulations that even, well, with certain caveats, that you really should be putting things in Zenodo because that's the kind of ERC approved
Yeah, for being an I just learned about Zenodo today. So I don't know if it's something really British, if it's anywhere
European,
but that's the first time I heard this this word. So I will check a little bit more on that.
All right. Well, thank you very much, and thank everyone. I thank everyone for coming today.